Good morning, everyone. Today, we will be discussing on the topic of significant figures. So, as you can see from the first slide, it says the definition of significant figures. So, this is the significant figures is the first topic that we will be discussing on the module one, that is your analytical chemistry. So what does significant figures means? I hope this, as you already told to me, that these term you have already learned in your smaller classes, so you are very well aware of it. So it would be just a brush up of what you have already learned. So to define what is significant figures, here it is, it says that it is defined as all those digits whose value are known with certainty, with one additional digit whose value is uncertain. So that means a significant figure, when we say that there is a significant figure, then that measurement or the value will contain a set of digits which are significant or which are known with certainty, and there would be one additional digit which is kind of an approximation or an uncertain digit. So that is what significant figures are comprised of in a measurement. So where do you find significant figures? Why this is so important? So in analytical chemistry, significant figures are very much important because the measurement that you make depends upon what instruments you are using for the measurement. So it depends upon the precision of that particular instrument. So accordingly, you will mention the digits in your measurement depending upon the precision of your instrument. For example, let us go to the next slide and we'll find the example. Suppose you are asked to weigh 2.34 gram of mass of a given salt in an analytical balance. So this is the analytical balance which I yesterday asked you, and you were like, we don't remember, this is just an instrument. Okay, so this is the analytical balance, and you are given this and you are asked to weigh 2.3 gram of mass of a given salt. So if you look at this particular instrument, you will find that this is comprised of how many decimal places? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so it comprises of 4 decimal places. So the precision, so this whole value would be the significant figure that is given by this particular instrument. So when you do the measurement, what happens? You measured a sample and you wrote down the value of the amount that you have measured as 2.3400. You just don't mention 2.34 because now you have measured this this salt on this particular instrument and it has 4 decimal places. So you have to mention all the 4 decimal places. So this whole value is a significant figures which has 1, 2, 3, and 4 of the digits which are known with certainty, and the last digit is a kind of approximation which is known with little uncertainty. So this whole term, which comprises of certain values as well as one uncertain value, is together called as a significant figure. So I hope now I have made clear what it is. So it is the significant figures comes into context when we talk about measurements using instruments, because there we come across the knowing of values or digits with certainty and those digits which are uncertain. So that's why this significant figures has much importance when it comes to analytical chemistry. Let's go to the next slide. So as I have told, number of significant figures in this case is 5. So it includes the certain digits as well as one uncertain digit. Now, when we are given a value, how to know which all are the significant figures in it? So there are certain rules. This also you might have studied previously. All the non-zero digits in a value or in a measurement are what? Significant. Then second rule says that zeros in between the significant figures are significant. So if you have a measurement and it has on the ends significant figures, and then in the middle you have zeros, then those zeros also will be counted as significant. Then zeros before or left of the significant figures are insignificant. So if you have certain number like 0.0045, then those 0.00, which are before the zeros before the significant figures, those would be not counted when you count the number of significant figures in a value. These decimal places are mainly used just to indicate the position of the value. Then the fourth rule says zeros after the significant figures may or may not be significant. This is very important. So all this rule we will just keep it in your mind, and let's go to the next slide and we will see through the example how to do that. So these are some of the measurement values that are given. So let's count how many significant figures are present in each of them. The first one, 26.38. So here, what do you find? How many number of significant figures? Since all is non-zero, so you can easily say that it has 4 significant figures. How about the second one? It is also very simple, 3 significant figures. Third one, see, non-zero digits are all significant. So here we have 4 and 6, which are non-zero, and 0 in between the significant figures. So obviously it will have 3 significant figures. And this just indicates zeros before the significant figures indicate just the position of the decimal point. So that means these zeros are insignificant. So what is remaining back? 500. So these zeros, which are after the significant figures, these will be counted. So now you have how many significant figures? 3 significant figures in this number. Now here again, you have 2.0. Now here also, it would have the 2 significant figures. Now here we don't have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the sixth number, you do not have a decimal place being mentioned. So whenever some random measurements are given in which you're not specified the decimal point, so it is not sure whether these zeros are significant or insignificant. So in such cases, when a whole number is being given to you and no decimal place or nothing is written about the position of the double decimal place, then that means you cannot for sure take these zeros as belonging to a significant figure. So that's why this one, if you are asked and you are not given any information, then that means it has only 1 significant figure. So decimal point in a number is very important. So whenever you give certain measurements in the using an instrument, you always mention the decimal point, because that signifies the precision of the value that you have measured. Now you might be aware of these scientific notations, so you can write certain numbers in a form of a scientific notation. So here you will write 2.0 into 10 to the power of 3. Suppose this number you are writing as a significant figure. Obviously, this has been written here in the form of a scientific notation. So when you want to write this as having only 2 significant figures, then how you will write as a scientific notation? You will write 2.0. So you have you're supposing the decimal points is here, so it will have to be moved from 1, 2, and 3. So 2.0 into 10 to the power of 3. Now this is called the significant or the mantissa in a scientific notation. So when you count, when you are given a value in a scientific notation format, then if you are asked to count the number of significant figures, then it would be only the digits in the mantissa is what you are going to count. So here in this case, it would be 2 significant figures. However, if you write this particular number as 2.00 into 10 to the power of 3, then that means this has 3 significant figures, and hence the number of significant figures would be 3. So it is pretty simple how you do this particular thing. Now, a second set of rules for additions and like when you use the measurement values for doing some kind of addition, subtraction, or multiplication or division, there are certain rules for that. Suppose when you are doing the addition and subtraction, the answer value, the final answer value, should have the number of digits to the right of decimal places equal to the number of number with least number of digits. So when you you have a set of measurements and then you add or subtract whatever you do, then what the final value that you get should have same number of decimal place as it is in the value which is having the least number of decimal places in your additions and subtraction. You will understand this when we do some examples. So here, then the second one is multiplication and division. Here the answer value will contain number of digits equal to the number of digits with least precise measurements. So if you have a certain amount of measurements and you multiply or divide, the final value should have same number of digits with the least precise measurement. So out of the three measurements you have multiplied or divided, the least precise measurement, how many digits are there? The answer value will have also the same number of digits. Okay, this will be more clearer when I show you the examples. So this is the addition. So when you add 3.4 plus 0.20 and 7.31, so if I ask you which is the least precise, okay, so you would quickly say that this is the least precise, because more precise means it will have more digits to show the precision of the measurement. So this is the least precise measurement. So that's why the least precise measurement, or the measurement with the least number of digits on to the right of the decimal place, is 3.4. So that means your answer, when you add this, you got as 10.73. The final answer that you mentioned should have only one decimal place. So that's why it should be 10.7. Okay. So this is how you do for additions and subtractions. Now, when you come to multiplications and divisions, so when you did this, you got this value. And I had told that you have to look into the least precise measurement. So out of these thing, which is the least precise, this would be the least precise, which has less number of significant figures. So that means only 2 significant figures are there. So in the final value also, you would prefer to have only 2 significant figures, and hence you will have a value that is 1.1, that you understood, right? Because the digit to be removed is more than 5, so obviously it should be rounded up to, you have to increase by 1, so it would be 1.1. Second case, again, you have 3 sets of values, you are multiplying and dividing, and you're getting an answer like this. And what you see here, the least number of significant figures is only 2. So that means your value should contain only 2 significant figures. So that means you can retain 9 and 6. So you will have the value that you will report as 0.96. Okay, so I hope I made this clear to you how the rules affects the addition and multiplications. Now, let's look into the when the plus minus, when you are doing the additions or subtractions with significant figures, an important thing that you must remember while you are doing additions or subtraction is that you have to express the number to the same power of 10. Matlab, when you add three values like 2.2 into 10 to the power of 3 plus 3.3 into 10 to the power of 4, then you have to match 10 to the power of 3 to 10, the second number to 10 to the power of 3 or the first number to 10 to the power of 4. So you have to maintain the power to the 10 on the same value. Only then you should add the mantissas. So that you should keep in mind while you are using significant figures, while you are using scientific notations. So there is a correction here. It's not significant figures, it's scientific notation. So whenever you are doing additions and subtraction using scientific notation, please correct this. This is not significant figures, it is scientific notation. So you understand, I have discussed just now what is scientific notation. So whenever you are doing additions and subtraction using scientific notations, you have to bring the powers of 10 to the same value, and then you add the mantissas. I hope I have corrected that thing. So keep in mind, this is not significant figures, but scientific notation. And this I have written shortly for additions and subtractions. Okay. So let's go to the final topic, and that is rounding off. This is also very important. So we just now saw how we rounded off the values. So that particular thing has certain rules, which you also might be aware of. Suppose the rule says that the last figure to be removed in a measurement is greater than 5, then you do plus 1. So if this is the value and you want to keep only 2 digits in the final value, depending upon whatever your need is, then you will write as 6.49 in this case, because the last digit to be removed is more than 5. So the last digit to be retained should be increased by plus 1. However, the second rule says that the last figure to be removed is less than 5, then no change. Suppose you want to keep 3 digits in this value. So 6.487 would be the answer, because the last digit to be removed is less than 5. So there will be no change that is happening in the final digit of the final value. Third rule says that if suppose the last figure to be removed is equal to 5 and it follows digits like 0, or there are no digits after 5, then you will add plus 1 if it is odd and no change if it is even. Let's look into this. Let's look into these values. So if you see here, what do you see? This one, this value, if you want to retain 6.75. Now the digit to be removed, that is here, the last digit to be removed is equal to 5 and it follows zeros. Okay, so that means the final digit to be retained, if it is what? Odd. If it is odd, then it should be increased by 1. So this, if you want to only retain 2 decimal place, the value you would be writing is 6.76, because the last digit to be retained is 5. Let's look here. This is 8.995. So here, suppose you want to retain only 2 digits, and this would be the last digit to be removed, and it is equal to 5, and it has following no zeros. So I have given in the rule that it follows zero or no digits at all. So here we do not have any digits. So, and the digit to be retained, final digit to be retained is an odd number. So you have to, whenever it is an odd, it should be increased by plus one. So when you add plus one to here, what will happen? The value will change to 9.00 because it become, you add it, right? So 0.001, if you add, becomes 10, it's become 10, and this become 9. So the value would be 9.00. This example, here what do you see? Suppose you want to only put one digit, retain only one digit after the decimal place. So it would be 6.6 only, because it is 5 equal to, last digit to be removed is equal to 5, and it is followed by 0, and the last digit to be retained is even. So when even, no change. So you will write the value as 6.6. Here also, if you want to retain two digits, you have to round it to two digit after the decimal place, then it would be 7.48, because here it's equal to 5 with no zeros and it is even. So even means no change. Then the fourth rule. Fourth rule says the last figure to be removed is equal to 5 and it follows non-zero numbers. Suppose it's equal to 5 and it is not followed by zeros or no numbers, but rather it is followed by non-zero numbers, then the last digit to be retained should be increased by 1. So here in this case, if you want to keep 1, the 5, it's equal to 5, last digit to be removed is equal to 5 and is followed with a non-zero number. So this would be 6.7. In this case, if you want to keep two decimal places, this value would be 7.49, because 5 is followed with the non-zero numbers. So this is all that is there in the significant figures, and please go through it, because I'll be putting some quizzes following this. If you have any doubts, please do let me know. I'll upload these videos in the Moodle, so you can look from there, and we will have a discussion class soon. I'll let you know the times. The books that I have followed for this particular class is the Puri and Sharma Inorganic Principle, as well as this particular book for Fundamental Analytical Chemistry. The pages I probably will upload in the Moodle classes, so you can refer to them. Okay, thank you so much for your patience while listening to me. So see you next time. Thank you.